Anyone in a hurry could easily overlook these movie posters. But each is one of a kind, hand-painted by Munich's last film poster painter. A piece of Hollywood on the outskirts of Munich, René Bilkner paints his large format movie posters in an old barn. In 1987, Bilkner, a former art student, found himself in the studio of a renowned Munich movie poster artist by chance. It led him to his profession.
I saw these huge surfaces, and the way they were painting became clear to me right away, because someone was working on the pictures right then. I was impressed, and I thought, I could do that too, and I'd like to.
Now, Bilkner's works can only be seen at a handful of cinemas in Munich. One of them is the Filmtheater am Sendlinger Tor. For four decades, Fritz Pressmer has managed this movie house, which dates back to 1913. Pressmer says mass-produced posters are out of the question.
The magic is that they're individually designed. For us as a cinema, that's very important, because 15 years ago, we could create our own newspaper ads, so the house had its own branding. Today, the distributor controls everything centrally. There's one ad motif for all of Germany. And this is the last place, the last refuge, where a cinema can still set its own very personal tone.
Bilkner gets new commissions every Monday. For example, the poster for the new Harry Potter film. Each poster costs around 1,000 euros. They have to be finished 3 days later and hanging on the cinema's facades. New pictures are painted on old canvases over the old posters. There's little time for nuance or detail.
For big pictures, you can outline the major elements rapidly using a very broad brush. For example, we won't draw in every line here, just more or less coarse graphic shapes. That's enough. Someone looking from several meters away won't see the difference. No one counts every line in someone's face anyway.
A Munich bank is now staging an exhibition of Bilkner's favorite posters. The painter himself loves broad, vibrant fields of color and striking portraits. The exhibition honors an almost forgotten craft.
It's got more life. When you see these colors and shadings, it's not the same as a normal movie poster. I definitely categorize it as an art form.
While Harry Potter dries without the aid of sorcery, René Bilkner continues with his next subject, U.S. actor Tom Hanks. Standard movie posters have changed a lot over the last 20 years.
Graphics don't play a major role. They don't try out different styles. The whole genre has changed a great deal, and for painters, it's no longer very interesting. They've all become too similar.
So interessant, es ist relativ gleichförmig.
Hand-painted film advertising conveys real emotions. And if you keep your eyes peeled as you stroll through Munich, you might spot a genuine Bilkner.